and welcome to the next episode of the AI Frontier series, a global collaboration between Reuters Plus and KPMG. I'm your host, Nadira Tudor, and in this episode, we'll be exploring AI adoption and value creation in the insurance sector, which by its very nature is risk averse. With a potential to revolutionize risk assessment, underwriting, and claims management, everyone from customers to employees to regulators stand to benefit from AI. According to KPMG's Intelligent Insurance Report, the impacts of AI on the sector will be transformative. Well, here to discuss this further, I'm delighted to be joined today by two KPMG executives and to hear from KBC Group. I'd like to start in London with Lloyd Hardwick. Lloyd, thank you for being with us today.
Thank you for having me. Good to meet you, Nadira.
So looking at the big picture, Lloyd, how do you expect AI to reshape the naturally cautious insurance industry over the next few years?
That's a great question. AI is reshaping the insurance industry. We're seeing a shift from reactive resolution to proactive prevention. Traditionally, insurers responded to a claim after the risk had occurred. Whereas AI is moving insurers from that traditional model, that traditional reactive model, to a preventive model through predictive analytics, real-time monitoring, autonomous decision-making, risk management is being transformed. It's this whole new concept of predictive maintenance and risk prevention that's leading to a reduction in claims and an overall better proactive customer relationship.
The pace of change you're describing is remarkable. We're seeing traditional insurance models being completely reimagined through technology with implications for everything from underwriting to claims processing. In your experience working with insurers across the UK, how can AI be leveraged to enhance customer experience and improve personalisation?
Yes, we're seeing AI revolutionising customer experience. It's being used to enhance, optimise and automate across every interaction that a customer has with an organisation. With more data readily available, AI is taking real-time personalisation to new levels. The tools that are changing how customers experience over sort of an AI-driven service. We're now able to use tools that are context-aware, agentic, autonomous AI systems that adapt interactions in real-time, creating more nuanced, human-like conversations through these advanced models where we have sentimental analysis, emotional recognition. We're able to tailor our responses based on customer emotions. In the future, we're going to be able to use the same models to predict how customers feel before they've actually expressed it, based on, again, previous behaviour and historical data.
For those insurance executives who may be hesitant about AI adoption, what would you say is the most crucial first step in their AI journey?
The first crucial step is to put the right foundations in place. This is fundamental, to have a defined, unified AI vision and strategy that the organisation is bought into, that it establishes a clear vision with a leadership commitment, recognising it as a strategic priority, communicating the importance of the strategy across the organisation, bringing together product innovation, customer success, data, ecosystem and partnerships, all tied to the same vision and goals. This is critical for the outset of bringing the teams together that are going to be delivering on this AI vision.
Thank you for those great insights, Lloyd, to start this discussion. I'd like to bring in KBC Group's Barak Chizi, who joins us from Belgium and is living some of these changes Lloyd has just described. Hello, Barak. Good to see you.
Hello, good afternoon.
Can you start by telling us a bit about KBC and give us a sense of the speed and scale at which AI is being implemented?
KBC is one of the leading financial institutes in Western Europe. We are mainly doing banking and insurance businesses. We have more than 40,000 employees around Europe. And we're using AI quite heavily. I think that since we started 10 years ago, we did more than 1,800 use cases of AI which ran on production. We take AI really seriously, and we are leading the next activities within AI to the next generation. Recently, we even established a transformation company named Disky where we sell our value proposition and our IP to other financial institutes.
Now, we're digging into the insurance sector's transformation. So, can I ask, how are these changes affecting KBC right now, and how do you see it developing?
So, we have this kind of change in two different verticals. The first one is about increasing our efficiency. We successfully managed to mimic our operations, taking from human experts to machine. So the machine can do the same thing like a human being and even better. For example, our claim handling process is done mainly by machine and in much better accuracy. Yeah. On the other hand, we're using AI in order to predict the intent of our customers and to offer our customers the right value proposition, the right solution, which is not necessarily related to banking and insurance, in the right moment, in the right context, and on the right channel.
Can you tell us about Kate, which I understand is the name of your fully digital assistant, recently rolled out to customers in Belgium and the Czech Republic? How is KBC leveraging AI to improve customer services?
I think that Kate is a very good example. By the way, Kate is serving not only our customers in Czech Republic and in Belgium, it's also serve our customers in Slovakia, in Hungary and in Bulgaria in a very successful way. Kate speaks 7 different languages, also speaks and also with chat. And what makes Kate a unique one is the fact that Kate is not just used in order to retrieve information and knowledge, but also enable our customer to execute end-to-end processes. For example, all the processes that can be done with a human being when he visits the branch or the agency can be done also with Kate 24/7. So we are now working on the next generation of Kate that will also enable other capabilities which are powered by a very strong generative AI, which is developed internally by KBC. KBC has a very big and scalable AI team. We have more than 100 data scientists around the group, which creating unique and internal IP that serves our customers and serve us in order to create better efficiency and better revenue.
Kate certainly does sound unique and fascinating, a perfect example of how, in its current iteration, AI is able to complement the needs of customers. So, within the insurance sector, AI appears to have multifaceted potential for customers. But Barak, I'm curious, what impact are new AI tools having on the mindset of KBC's own workforce?
I think that our workforce is changing rapidly from more domain experts based decision, we are coming or moving towards more data-driven decision-making. By the way, at KBC, we don't have AI strategy. We have company strategy, which are powered by AI tools and by AI initiatives. So we are trying to make our own decision and to create our own leverage by basing ourselves more on quantified tools rather than on subjective assessment. This is actually what makes KBC so unique and so profitable.
So interesting. And if I could bring in KPMG's Ilanit Navon Adesman now, who's based in Israel. Hello, Ilanit. Now, we've just heard Barak talk about how AI is impacting KBC Group as a financial risk management partner. How do you see the regulatory landscape evolving to accommodate these changes?
So AI can also leverage regulation. Insurance companies as financial institutions, which are very highly regulated, can leverage the use of AI also for some of the regulatory aspects. For example, KYC AML processes in many insurance companies today are still very manual. So it can also help us in the insurance industry as a whole to automate these processes, make them much more effective and much more customer friendly. Other use cases that we see in the landscape of AI in regulation in insurance is for anomaly detection. Also in insurance, as mentioned, claims processes are being automated today with AI. Of course, it's not only the automation, but also the fraud detection that make them much more effective. And the last example, how AI can help us with regulation for the companies who are under SOX, Sarbanes-Oxley. It can also help the controls and to make all the controls instead of departments of hundreds of people. AI can help and do it much more effectively and with greater samples and with less mistakes.
It's certainly clear that care is needed at every step of the journey. And this must also count for the investment side of AI implementation too. But how is success being measured with things developing so quickly? What is best practice when it comes to insurers effectively measuring return on investment of AI initiatives?
So we need to clarify on which side we are looking, on the income or on the expenses. So in insurance companies, usually for all kind of companies, of course, but for insurance companies specifically, we measure it with KPIs. For the revenue side, of course, we need to look on new products that are being developed thanks to AI. The insurance industry as a whole in the last 20 years got very digital and more direct companies, direct agents and so on. But the products themselves did not change that much. AI is helping us to change the products and make products that are more personalized, more personalized for the customer needs in the right time, at the right cover that they need. So bringing in some new products and measuring the profit from those products are, of course, one side. The other side is with effectiveness. I think that we are seeing in many companies KPIs who are checking the effectiveness of a team and how the same kind of team with the company's development with new products of AI can handle much more claims, much more new policies, with the same amount, much more IT developments with the same amount of people, only much more effective. And this also is being measured with KPIs dedicated to this.
It seems to be a very pragmatic approach as AI takes on increasingly complex tasks in risk assessment and underwriting. How can insurers ensure that human oversight and judgment remain at the heart of decision-making processes?
So, of course, we still have the human in the loop. We don't need to leave, especially for the high-risk processes, the humans outside of the processes. Humans still need to monitor what AI is doing. Of course, before implementation of new models, to do stress testing, to see that there is no bias, which of course insurance companies suffered before from lawsuits about discrimination and so on. So in order to avoid it, of course, the human in the loop is very important to check the results of the AI and to measure if there are any biases from the decision of AI. Of course, training to the employees is also very important in order to make sure that we manage the risk of AI properly.
Barak, if I can come back to you now and ask, how do you see AI evolving at KBC and how important human oversight will be going forward?
So I think that for us, it's very crucial to have the right ratio between AI and human. Of course, as time goes by, we see more and more AI taking over about processes that were done previously by a human being. It will be always the case that we will need the human touch on the niche cases, but we do think that AI bring us to a position that we can understand much better our customers' behavior and put her on every decision junction that a person, one of our clients, would need to take a financial decision for his life, for his career, and for different things that he will encounter within his journey or her journey.
Thank you for your insights. Your perspective on balancing AI innovation with sound risk management principles gives us a clearer picture about how insurers can navigate this transformation responsibly.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.